You join me today on a Delta Junction in a location of the River Tame West Viaducts. And today marks the moment when the team have completed our first section of precast segmental viaduct for this asset. Once complete, this asset will carry three lines of HS2 rail traffic, critically to the north. The viaducts are part of a group of 13 viaducts, which make up HS2 Triangular Delta Junction. This section of the railway enables high-speed trains to travel between London, Interchange Station in Solihull and Baron Curzon Street Station.
This viaduct is 472 meters long and it's composed of 190 segments. Each one of the two viaducts we've got for River Tame West, we have one double track and one single track, which will carry a three-rail track for the high-speed train. On my right-hand side, there is Water Horton 1, and on my left-hand side, there is Water Horton 2. There is also River Tame East single track. So in total, surrounding me, there is five viaducts.
The precast segmental viaducts are built with the span-by-span construction methodology, using the cantilever spans to balance the rear span to use for the cantilever spans being constructed. We are using the technique of the stay mast with temporary cable stays and the swivel crane for the final erection. So each span is composed of 19 segments, which are erected one after each other, and this process takes almost 5.5 days. So the segments, they are stored at site in a laid-on segments laid-on area. They are prepared for final erection. Once they are prepared, they are transported by means of a self-propelled modular transporter along the deck for final erection by means of the swivel crane. We will then glue the interior section with an epoxy adhesive. Then the segments will be lowered, and then inside the box girder, we will be assembling a series of temporary PT bars that will connect the segments. Then when this will be done, the swivel crane will be moving to the erected segments, and then a pair of cable stay will be attached to the erected segments.
So today we are installing the last segment of River Tame West single track, which is the SOA on top of the last abutment. Due to the design of the viaduct, they require to be heavier. To minimize the design and the cost on the manufacture of the swivel crane and the mast, instead of designing a swivel crane which will cover all the lifting requirements based and composed with the heavy lifting of the SOA, we have mitigated the dimension of the swivel crane to cover 98% of all our lifting, but the SOA need to be lifted by a mobile crane because they are too heavy for the swivel crane.
We have chosen for the precast segmental viaduct the technique of the stay mast and the swivel crane because it's a flexible methodology, especially because we have nine independent viaducts to build across the Delta Junction. The advantage of this technique is the initial assembly of the equipment, of the mast and swivel crane, and the dismantling duration that allows for quick inter-site moves. So we are capable to restart after having complete one viaduct, to restart as soon as we can the next viaduct. So the next step for this viaduct is to start with superstructure construction. So in terms of superstructure, there is a lot to do. We have to install all the parapets, will be installed along the edge of the viaduct on either side. Then we will have to stitch those parapets and start the construction of the robust curb. When the robust curb will be done, then we will construct the walkways, which are in between the robust curb and the parapet stitch. And then we will build all the remaining cable trough and OCS mast foundations.
This is a significant construction milestone for the team. So it's the first time in the UK we use iterative technique to install segments on a viaduct in this way.
This is a great achievement that all the team shares and everybody is very proud of it. It's a big success that has required a lot of effort and commitment from everybody, the supply chain, our partner, our own people, and of course from the HS2, the senior management and department.
Alors for me, personally, it's a fantastic day today because it is the achievement of years of engineering and presence on this project. This is the moment where we are capable to demonstrate that we are capable here in the UK to build precast segmental viaduct with a technique that has never been employed here in the UK, which is efficient technology, which allows us to achieve a production which is incredibly quick, let's say. And we were capable to train and gather people that were not familiar with this technique in order to achieve this production output.